Hello all and welcome to video classes by Connor Institutes. Today we will be discussing two topics which are microeconomics and macroeconomics. In the last class we have discussed who are called as the producers, who are called as consumers, yes. And even we have discussed the definitions of economics and also what is the economic activities. So let's understand today what is the microeconomics. So if you just look into your textbooks, they have given certain meanings for microeconomics, yes? So the word micro means very small. So here we are talking about small units or small components. Let's say an individual. So for example, if you consider me here, so the utilization of the resources, the unlimited wants. So here we are discussing about the microeconomics. Microeconomics is a study of decision making to use resources by smallest components of the society. So as I have said, if you are taking me as a component here, so I'm being considered here as a small component because we are not talking about very large entity, we are not talking about something in the total. What we are doing here is we are talking about something which is very small, right? So that's what called as microeconomics. Here when I'm talking about me as an individual, we are talking here about what are my resources, how I am going to utilize my resources to satisfy my unlimited wants. So that comes under the microeconomics. So here they have given some of the smallest components, which are individual, households and the organization. So individuals come under microeconomics. Yes. Next we have households, which we have even discussed, which was a Greek word defined as oikos, right? And next we have organization, or with even we have called it as a firm. So these considered under microeconomics. You have to buy certain goods and services to satisfy your wants. So when we are talking about an individual, when we are talking about a household or a family, when we are talking about the organization, here we have to discuss how they are going to satisfy their unlimited wants with the limited resources. So that comes under the microeconomics. So when it comes to goods and services, what thing first comes to your mind? Let's say I want to buy a book. Yes, this is a part of goods, right? When I am deciding to buy a book, there will be so many questions which will be coming to me in my mind, right? So what are these questions? First, which book I am going to purchase? Yes, so there are so many brands or so many book products which we have available in our market, right? So first I have to decide which product book I am going to purchase. Next, what quality I am looking for, how much price I am looking for, is it going to fit into my budget or not? These all are the questions which I have to first think of, then I can go for purchasing this book. Next we have a production or a business unit, which is called as a firm. We were all, as I have mentioned here, organization or firm, which is also considered as an individual unit, which comes under the microeconomics. So when we are talking about the firm or an organization, even organization has to produce one or the other products, yes? So when they are producing the products, they have to again think of those decisions, think of those situation wherein they have to fit into that situation, right? So we have also discussed about this pen, right, in the previous class. So when the producer wants to produce this pen, they have so many questions in front of them. how what raw materials they have to utilize, whether they have to manufacture this with the help of the technology or the labor intensified or the capital intensified. Yes, so these all questions come into picture. So these all the questions come under microeconomics. Next we have the products which are being produced and under this production unit, right? So they have that quantities, how much quantity they have to produce, what quantity needs to be produced, how we are going to utilize the raw materials, and who will be our targeted customer. So these all the questions or these all the components of what we study comes under this microeconomics. And next, the price is determined by the interaction of the buyers and the sellers in the market. So when we are talking about a product or certain goods and services, so how we are putting the, or how we are deciding the price of that product. So here what happens is the buyer and the seller will be deciding the price of that product. So even that comes under the microeconomics. So how they are interacting, or on what basis they are deciding, or on a mutual acceptance of the prices, that all been discussed under the microeconomics, right? Next we will discuss the macroeconomics. So here I had said, here this is a smaller component, whereas when we are discussing this macroeconomics, it is a larger component, or we can say total. Here we were studying of a individual, yes, whereas when we are talking about the macroeconomics, what we are doing here is we are not studying of an individual or single person. We are discussing here, or we are talking about the entire community, which is a larger community. So that comes under the macroeconomics. The word macro means total or large, means this is not just one individual or one single person. We are talking about the entire community, or we can say that whole country. Yes, so that comes under the macroeconomics. The society or the country or an economy is a very large unity, right? So when we are talking about the country, we don't have a single person in a country. We have very, very huge population, right? So when we are talking about this macroeconomics, we consider the entire population. So that comes under the macroeconomics. Some decisions have to be taken under the aggregate level, right? What we are doing here is we are summing up everything here. We are not just taking one single component here. I'm not talking about the component of this person. I'm not even talking about this. What I'm doing here is I'm constituting all the components. So what I'm doing here, I'm summing up all, means which is nothing but the aggregating. The economic decisions taken at the level of the economy as a whole are the subject to the microeconomics. Yes, what I'm doing here is I'm considering everything. I'm not just talking about a single person. So economic decisions are like a collection of taxes. Yes, government, what it does it just collect taxes from a single person? No, what it does, it collects taxes from everyone, right? The citizen of the country. So that comes under the macroeconomics. Next, expenditure on public amenities or the welfare activities. So the road facilities which we have received from the government, the hospitalities, yes. Is it just only dedicated for a single person? No, it has been dedicated for all the citizens of the country. So this, the entire unit of larger components comes under the macroeconomics. The regulation of inflation. We have discussed about this, right, in the last class, inflation. What is this called? Sudden raise in the prices. So that's called as the inflation. Promotion of economic growth, etc., which affect the whole economy, fall under the purview of the macroeconomics. So whatever we are studying here, the larger unit, which is inflation or the economic growth plans of the country, which comes under the macroeconomics. We have something called as consumption expenditure. Okay, we'll understand more better what is consumption expenditure. You have already known, right? This is part of the economic activities. Yes, we have four components which makes us the economic activities. One was the production, second was the consumption, third was the exchange, and fourth one was the distribution. So in that we have already discussed the consumption, right? Consumer consumes the products which are being produced by the producers, so that we call it as the consumption by the consumer. So what is consumption expenditure? If you remember, I had taken an example of this pen where I was telling you about this as a product, right? Me as a consumer and the producer of this is called the production, who has done the production of this pen is called as the producer. So when I am utilizing this pen, I am called as the consumer. So consumption expenditure is nothing but the expenditure which I have made for consuming this pen. That is called as the consumption expenditure. If you are purchasing a book, then you have consumed that book, right? So that book becomes your consumption expenditure. So that's which comes under the macroeconomics. Similarly, we add up all the incomes of the individual in the society, it becomes the total income of the country. So as I said, we are not just talking about the single person here, we are talking about the entire group. Okay, so if we are talking about the single person income, that comes under the microeconomics. If we are talking about the income of entire group or the population of a country, then it comes under the macroeconomics. Similarly, we have problem of unemployment. Yes, we have economic growth, development affect the whole nation. So what are these economic growths? We have discussed these also in the last class, right? The 5-year plans or the transportation facilities which the government is giving us, the construction of the buildings or the hospitalities. Yes, these all are the economic growth which the government is providing to us. So these all comes under the macroeconomics. In very simple, if we have to define this microeconomics and the macroeconomics, then we can say a tree, yes? A tree from a forest, and this is a big forest. Yes? Here we are just talking about a single tree from a forest. Whereas in the macroeconomics, we are not talking about a single tree. Here we are talking about the entire forest. That's the meaning of microeconomics and the macroeconomics. I hope you have found this video interesting. And in the upcoming classes, we can even discuss the question answers. I just ask you to solve the fill in the blanks and also the 1-mark questions. Yes. And in the next class, we can discuss more on this chapter and the question answers. Let's see in the next class.